Do I need a mic? No?
No.
You get it from the camera? Yeah, that's good. So, we'll start the app clinic. People on the back of the room, there are three seats there. Just join us. You want to leave? So, the principal, who knows what the app clinic at Embrin Makers format is? Raise your hand if you already seen it. Okay, so let's explain for a few people. The app clinic session is something like a very casual moment that we spend with a panel of wonderful GDEs and that will review in life, and for the first time they will see some applications. These applications have been submitted by some attendees and sometimes some organizers, some speakers, just to try to improve ourselves altogether. And the idea is to try to find better way to do things on apps, and we do that as a first onboarding in an application. Am I explaining it very clearly? No? Yeah? Okay. You will understand. And they all know the format, so that's good. The setup is pretty simple. I have this Nexus 6 phone, and there are these applications. You will see everything on the screen, because we will use a very, very nice tool that will be maybe work one day. Oh no.
Demo effect.
Demo effect, of course. And cable effect, actually. So let's try it on the other way.
The EDB effect.
Permanent.
No way! Okay. It was working just 1 minute ago.
We're gonna have binoculars. Everyone can see the
It's good, no?
It's actually just going to be an hour of us trying to deploy and getting
So we're going to do an app clinic on ADB.
Yeah.
Oh, that's going to take a couple of hours.
It's working, guys. It's fine. It's fine. Why do you stress like this? So you see there are these six applications that have been submitted. There is a backup using Jellymotion on the desktop. If in some way the device failed and you don't have time to just solve it. But so we'll try it and just open this application as a first user. So the common stage. We can just split the group and have a few people there and other people here. Okay, so we are just all in front of it. Yeah. And we need to just take our turn to open applications. Okay? So who wants to try first? Cyril, I know that you are very good at this.
No.
So
I'm late, so I
last to run first.
Yeah. You are late, so you will do it first. Come on, man. Round of applause. So we'll start with the Sester's application.
So first, let's look at the icon, I guess.
Yeah.
So I'm the only one doing it.
No. Just and if somebody has new comments and things to add to what you are saying, it's all good. Okay.
So first, I think the good thing to look at is, I don't know the version of this Android phone.
It's the not the very last one, but the one before on the last story.
So do we have adaptive icons?
Yeah.
Okay. So I think here you have like for Chrome or camera that the adaptive icon is actually square normally. So I would expect this icon to be square too, so maybe it would be nice to have an adaptive icon to just to fit to the Android system right now. But what the good thing I like here is that the style is really material, so we have a long shadow, and the icon is pretty simple and is a good metaphor for me of what it does. But I actually maybe I'm not the correct guy about that because I already know the app. So I know what it's doing inside, but you can expect it to manage money or something. Mm. I don't know if you have other comments regarding the name or...
By the way, it's looking at me because I did it.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Oh, sorry. That's something I totally forgot. So people are submitting, and I hope developers are in the room, and they are extremely brave and really, really nice to just propose their application as a judgment. Everybody will be very kind and constructive because that's really the first goal of this session. learn together about how to improve our, all our implication together and really be very kind. That's the main principle.
We thought that the main goal was making fun of them.
Man, we are French, but we cannot do it up internally.
So let's open it. So I'm just adding on it. And the good thing here is that it starts quickly. I just killed the process, so it's really a cold start and it starts very quickly. And then it shows what it does, I guess. A trip with a friend or your common challenges creating project. So yeah, for me it's quite straightforward. We know what it does. And the presentation is quite simple because it says you have to create a project, but it's not automatically creating the project for you. It shows you what to do. So it forces you to learn about it. And as you may have guessed, I mean, there is only two actions on this screen. So it's the next at the top or the plus at the bottom right. So it's pretty straightforward.
Can you scroll?
Sorry?
Yeah. Can you
I can scroll with the next or, yeah, you can see at the bottom.
Yeah, well, you don't get that you can scroll.
Okay,
so
even when there is one.
Yeah. So is that it's automatic? But because as a text, it's
no, 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 don't do automatic. No, no.
Yeah.
That's a bad idea.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, the first impression is that there's so many things going around that you have a few call to actions. So I don't know, like if why this is not in part of the onboarding? I'm just
Because I don't like onboarding. I don't want to be stuck within the screens of tutorials. I want to use it. Know the app, you can just go.
Yeah.
Ah, so this is the app already, like
it is already the app.
You can start
projects.
Right.
Yeah.
The one thing I'm not entirely sure about is the next button
there.
Is this not where people usually
I was also thinking that on smaller density devices, with the what it looks like a collapsible toolbar at the top, is this going to have to scroll vertically at some point? Do we have some vertical scroll in this to get down to the indicators as well?
Does just a question to the audience. Does everybody see the screen correctly? Because I know there are a lot of sound outside. Yeah, it's good for everybody.
Except for us.
We don't even see it.
No,
exactly.
We can just
know what
we're seeing.
I don't know if you're okay with that, Taylor, but I know that sometimes it depends, but just to show you that it's scrollable, just to have like a quick animation, like
definitely a hint,
hint.
It's good.
Yeah.
I also think that, I don't know, like the toolbar area thing could be optimized a little bit, taking too much space, and this is the screen when the user first launched the app, right? And as I said, there's so many call to action that the users will try to figure out, like, what should I do next? And of course, there's a next button, of course, but there's also a plus button, there's a toolbar, so it's not focused enough.
Yeah.
So probably just a little bit more streamlined, I think, would be better.
I understand the intention of saying, well, you don't have an onboarding, you go straight to where you can create content, but you do, now you have both in the same screen. And it's like, it is my first reaction.
It's scoring.
Okay. Just discovered it.
The first reaction was, was, do I need to press the plus? Do I need to go next? What does happen when I get to the end?
Yeah.
Like, the two things being on screen at the same time are maybe a bit overwhelming.
Yeah.
But also, like, can you do anything with first creating a project?
Oh.
Then I would just have like a one graphic and one button.
Press it to
create
first project.
So we start with the
you can make this first screen of onboarding. You can make this first screen of onboarding your empty state in the app. And then you can present them with this main screen, which has only the first screen of onboarding as the empty state and a button.
Yeah, big button.
Yeah.
And you can even collapse the three action points into like one graphic.
Yeah, exactly.
Create, share,
block.
So I've just tapped on the plus button, and now we're, I guess, in a wizard to create a new project. So for me, it's pretty straightforward. That's the title, so Android Makers. And then you have to set contributors. So let's say, okay. Then the currency.
Yeah.
list.
Yeah, you need a search.
Yeah, but it's alphabetical order. I don't know. For search for three letters, it's kind of hard. And if you need a symbol, it's you can search for a symbol. Otherwise,
you
just
maybe you can have people search for the actual name. So if I search pound,
you should actually add it.
Maybe I don't know.
Yeah, true.
And is it actually necessary? I mean, so you can do a list of different currencies.
I mean, for example, you can be on the. I can go in Europe, but I can go in US, and I want to have different currencies.
Okay, in the same project.
Right now, you cannot.
Okay,
it's planned.
So you want to have the data.
We get it.
Where are your users?
So let's say
both Europe, mostly in France, and some in US.
Then it might be best to kind of start with your common ones, and then a separate maybe column feature that
I think it's starting with the dollar and
But maybe even two different lists.
A very clear separation between the most common one and then the rest.
Sectioning maybe.
Just in terms of the context, not having seen this app before, and not having seen the Play Store listing, what is like the short description of what it should do?
It was within your onboarding.
So it's to share expenses.
Exactly.
But I really could be.
Can you
hit
plus? I've never seen before.
Sorry.
Can you go to the website?
Can you
give me
a one?
I think for the screen we were just looking at, my biggest advice would be to put sensible defaults on this screen. So here you have to pick the category.
So focus on the primary usage, like contributors on title.
Yes, specifically, exactly. They just want to get in there. Later they may want to pick
Hinge for the field, it feels kind of weird.
Title.
Yeah, it is autofilling with a name. So either you want to mark that it's not important for autofill, or something specific. I mean, it probably inferred that itself somehow, but you may want to tell it, don't do that.
Yeah. If you wanted to do an inline hint as well, that might be able to get you a little more space on the screen and look a little more compact and more visible. I feel like keeping the title up above it while, because you have a lot of space in that classic keyboard layout, that does feel like it's not ideal like space.
It's also a chance for the light. You can have like funny hints for something to share, like, I don't know, time machine, whatever, like coming straight there.
And here I would expect the keyboard to hide, actually, because I was actually setting the contributors, and now I'm on the symbols, so I have the hero. I'm not expecting you know to change the title anymore, so dismiss the keyboard. And I have to do it manually if you like.
I do like the done button there. It's very clear. Like,
you can
get right back into it.
And despite the fact that the white and yellow is not much contrast, but I do like the colors.
You can define it. So AI is everywhere.
Basically, it's my
surprise. You are a category, you are a title, you are whatever.
I know you love
me.
Is there a currency as well?
Oh, you can also info the project.
Can you
if you know your project, you can info it. So,
ID from.
One question.
Yes.
From the list of contributors, why not propose you to import your contact list from
because of the permission? Before, I mean, I can do permission only above 6, but the navigation like that asking for permission for contacts when I click on the button, it feels like.
I think that would be exactly the right time to ask
permission. You can also have it in the dialog.
You can have it one step in. When you click on contributors, you could have this, and then where below where it says name of the contributor, it could say
use your
contacts. And that is, at that point, you know 100% the user wants you to ask for.
And you have to explain
it's very, very clear.
It might be, if you're concerned about the permission, you can make that Marshmallow Plus
crazy idea is that for the currency, you could use like the course location to know approximately where people are in the world.
It stays on your local on your phone, so it's actually the first one is the currency on your phone.
Interesting.
Not the list is not ordered, it's just the different ones is the one.
Okay.
You could probably section that to say like based on your locale and
for the location.
But you can have both. You can have different sections, even repeat the currencies. There's nothing such a way.
We have 1 minute left for this application.
Yeah. So just one remark, because we're telling you to add a lot of stuff in dialogues, but I think maybe it's not a good choice to have a dialog anymore if you want to add a search or add like add from context to pattern. So maybe I would like try to switch to another screen, but I know that it's kind of difficult because you lose the context from the form itself. So maybe having like an expandable or something like that that would like still keep the context but have like more space than just a dialogue.
There was a trade-off.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
A long time ago.
Yeah.
And that's, yeah. So you can import, but maybe you don't have to.
Yeah.
Let's look at the
view.
Just go to the project.
Yeah,
yeah.
We can just
create
check.
One. So when I create a project, I'm not in project.
Yeah,
there was a list of your project.
Yeah.
I feel like there's not enough differentiation.
Yeah.
I agree.
Yeah.
In those two screens.
Yeah. Maybe you could tint the toolbar just to show that you're in the list or in detail.
Where you can have the users pick a color for the project. So it's also a way to tag them visually.
Maybe you could also use Vulti or give some
life
to your...
Or if there's any sort of concept of like an icon or something that they want to associate with the project, you could use something like palette to take the primary color from it.
Yeah, maybe there's something that you can tell Stan about this project and the team working on this project. Who are they?
So we have two ex-roommates, and basically we wanted an app which is doing expenses, but wanted to be able to export the data, wanted to be a bit more transparent and be able to go to Google Drive and access all the data. That was not possible.
So does the application store the data only locally?
So right now it's locally when you save, but then you can export it. So
okay.
It really, then you create an ID. This is what you share with your friends with a password or not, and so you can import that on the web or on your iOS.
Okay.
Okay, cool. Thanks a lot, Stan. You want to stay?
No.
Halo.
Let's go.
Alex, always here.
Yeah, so I think next
her
is yours. Now.
Yes.
Yeah.
No, she didn't see, so just watch it. Very closely, because the next application is yours,
okay? Okay. Maybe Sarah will go first, because he was late.
Okay, Taylor, you can open this anymore.
I mean, you just have to type
randomly. Give me feedback.
Yeah, let's do the monkey.
Okay, let's do it.
Monkey testing.
Icon looks good, of course. The logo is very unique.
Yeah, is there the developer in the room? Just come on stage.
No. I did it, because I want to relook on the icon. So yeah, it should have the adaptive icon, of course.
Okay, just before opening the application, maybe Julien, you can just give us more context about what is this application.
Oh, it's IMDb-like, so but a bit more social. So yeah.
Okay, it's good. It's enough.
Okay, sure. So first launch. You ask for location.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, but
it depends on the use case, you know, like we always want to push the permission asking until the last minute before you require that. So
I don't know. I don't have any context of why.
Yeah, exactly.
If you have to ask at the very first, you may want to consider showing your own dialogue before you ask the system dialogue.
Or your onboarding first, maybe, that explains the value add to the user.
Yeah.
Or maybe a card in the main layout saying, if you do give us permission that we can show cinema times around or something like that.
Yeah.
I tried to say no.
Yeah, definitely. that's usually the user would do.
Did we just lose functionality because we denied location? Like, what changed?
There's a nearby looking icon. We can try clicking on that.
This one?
Oh, that's not the nearby.
Yes, the nearby. Yeah,
a compass.
Okay. Okay, let's start with the home again. Let's see what's there. So you can do boot refresh. You can see timing. Okay.
So wait, it does work without boot refresh. Right?
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
So you can at least start with the.
Well, the basic location is Paris.
I see.
Okay.
So you're lucky now.
is the you know, the recommended one. Okay, the slider is it's at one point I don't feel like it's a slider, so maybe it can be changed to the dot one, or you know, just to make it clear that for card base.
It looks like you can actually drag it.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I thought it was a progress bar at first. It's like, oh, it's trying to do something. Yeah. Okay, so that's moving. Let's scroll to the bottom. You see more. Okay, you have ratings. Yeah, again, you know, the scroll bars is...
It looks like we're having the scroll bar on some of them, but not on others.
Yeah, so those that have the, you know, the hint that you can scroll without the scroll bar, but those without, there's a scroll bar. I think as a designer, I do think that I understand that, but most of the users probably will look at it and just scroll it.
Maybe you can make those full width items slightly smaller.
Yeah, that's
and
exactly
leave
what I was gonna
like
say,
a
yeah.
bunch of pixels of the next
you
one.
You can still get
in.
That visual effect of
yeah.
a big picture.
Yeah.
And
I had a comment about the stars.
Yeah, sure.
You're showing both the number of stars and the stars. Maybe it's redundant. You could just show a star just to say this is the number of stars and then the number.
And then oh, this is the average ratings.
Yeah, but like the same you do for the emojis after.
Mm-hmm.
If you scroll down. So here you just say emoji and the number.
Yeah.
You can do the same with a star. Like star and then number. So that is either one.
Or if you wanted to keep the stars, you could save the number itself, the more detailed number,
yeah.
for once
yeah.
they're on a detailed view.
Yeah.
Okay, so
reach
to the end. You need some
overscroll
effect, just to communicate that. So let's try to tap on the timing. Let's say on the watch, not today, but 2 days after, so on the 26th. Okay, what does it say?
Let's do it again.
Oh,
I think it doesn't want you to look at them.
It's jumping
around. Check back later.
Check back later? Okay, so I can only...
It was too fast to read
and
the whole thing.
That's
so
just
yeah.
Wait,
yeah, the
maybe
this, yeah, then this bar. Message is, you know, is dismissed too fast. So
mm-hmm.
probably you can consider using the stack bar, or yeah, because like even if it's in English, I will not be able to catch it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Also,
so
if that's disabled, you might not allow the user to actually click that. You might make that a
yeah.
disabled state.
Oh yeah, exactly. That's true.
Although, like clicking and explaining why it's
disabled,
yeah,
in a
way.
Yeah, depends on the.
At least take out the click of the selectable background, so you can tap it. It doesn't do anything, and then it tells you, well,
yeah,
not
yeah,
yet.
Actually, it's a bit,
yeah.
And make this not very visible, so either like the black background or even the same red that you're using for the.
Yeah. Well, maybe that's a bit too much.
Maybe it is, but like it's very clear.
Let's see if the search works. So I think there's only two syllables.
Is that doing a local search or a web search?
Web search.
Then is there an I didn't see an indicator pop up that we were doing a network request or that the user might be delayed before that shows. Like you put in
I think he has existing data though, so unless you want to blow away the list while searching.
Well, he said it's a web search, not a local search, so there might be.
I mean, you could just temporarily
even if you did it like in
yeah.
the field with like a little spinner or something.
Yeah, something
yeah.
in line, but, yeah.
Instead of the magnifying glass, you could just put a,
yeah.
A small spinner and then
yeah,
replace
yeah.
it again.
Yeah.
You can use AVDs to make it nice.
Yep.
I like
so
that.
You can tap on the time or, or just
and I was,
the
I'm also a huge fan of query highlighting because I want to know when I'm typing
yeah.
a query why a search result pops
yeah.
up. So I like to have like query highlighting like using bold or whatever, just to show you that when you type BU, it's
yeah.
because of publicity.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Also, I'd like to know when it's done, so that it doesn't jump when I'm about to click something.
Yeah.
You mentioned in the Twitter effect.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's machine learning.
Yeah,
the
moving.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can you try to type just UV, for instance?
Sure.
Okay, so it starts for, it looks for the words, actually, not for some parts of the words.
It starts.
Oh, no, to have. Okay, so I would only search
because generally you don't look for, instance, the second result. I don't know why. It's here.
Yeah.
It's,
I guess it's in the address.
So
also we're seeing more now.
Yeah.
As opposed to the default.
No. Yeah.
So is that intended, or is this list correct?
I guess, yeah.
You know, I mean, I would only look for the word starting with this certain word.
Yeah, because the default wheel is only two, so I would expect when I search, I only see either one or none of them.
Unless there was an indicator that said like more or something that allowed you to patch a name.
Yeah.
That's maybe because of the,
connection.
So can you say just cinema without the accent? Because in France we have lots of accent.
Yeah.
And then E, just E. Okay, so
I will
this
do
is my, in French, sometimes you don't type the accent in search, and you want the search result to come. So it's really nice.
Yeah.
I know that people from the US don't
care.
Okay. We can when we get the complaints from French users.
Okay, so so this is what happened when I tap on the location bar.
So I need to log in.
Connection.
Yeah. Do you want to log in?
Okay,
so log in or cancel.
Okay.
Yeah.
But does it explain what it's doing?
It's saying you need to log in to do this.
Yeah.
Do you want to log in?
I don't know what this is.
What do we
that,
yeah, what
yeah,
do we
it's
do?
Pretty the message is pretty general here.
Okay.
Yeah, this is for toggling the like of cinemas, not for our login.
Yeah, maybe you could have some graphics so you can make it look nicer and say, maybe try to explain what is the actual value of that, because if you just hit the login screen, it's like, yeah, but I don't care too much. So
also,
if you
just to make this prompt a little less generic, it says you need to log in to do this action. If we don't know what we hit, we don't even know what the action is.
Yeah.
So in the screen it can say, you need to log in to like a movie.
Yeah.
But I think I like the effect where you press and it becomes smaller. It's super subtle. But on the icon.
This
yeah,
icon?
Smaller, yeah.
Where is the icon?
That's kind of really
or
super
subtle.
Oh,
okay.
Oh, yeah.
So the bounce
okay.
effect.
Like
okay.
And can you type connect here just to maybe there is the information you asked for.
Oh, okay,
so
you can connect.
So just to show you why, no explanation on what it brings to connect.
Yeah.
Once this is done, do you preserve the action that the user was doing?
You mean the last screen?
Yes.
I think so.
It should, yes.
Yeah.
So if it doesn't, it should.
Just a heads up, you will also get a lot of people asking, why can I not connect with Google?
I don't have Facebook.
Is this
cancel so.
Or?
Yes.
Later.
Oh, later. But
is it
well, yeah, no, it's tappable actually. So
okay.
I don't think it should be this in this
it
color.
Like
it looks disabled,
yeah.
And I was just trying to see if I can.
Yeah.
No, it's actually canceled. So I just need to try it. So
it's a non-call to action because they don't want to push the button.
I know. I definitely understand. You definitely want the user to actually connect, but it doesn't mean that you should try to confuse the user. Like,
so this is a very system-disabled color, so maybe you can make your action buttons something like the app's color, like the red perhaps.
Yeah, or you can just use a back button.
Or reduce the size.
Yeah. Well, back button is the same obfuscation than changing the color from this. That is standard, so can you
You also, I mean, the fact that there's a line and then the later button is the biggest button on screen.
It's actually captured a little bit more attention, right?
Yeah.
This is why the first thing I tried that. And I was like, okay, it looks, All right, so.
Do we have the screen?
Let's go to the cinema. So I think this is showing the real map image of the location of the cinema. It's pretty much.
Just one detail about the phone configuration, it's in English, US English. So if you see a French application, it means that the application does not support English, right?
Yeah.
Which might be okay if the content you provide is only in French, obviously.
Yeah.
Because
of course.
What about the date picture? Can you select other dates, like the 29th?
No, okay, you can scroll. 1 week,
You want to sit a little bit hidden, maybe?
Yeah, absolutely.
Do this,
yes.
So it looks like you are not formatting the dates with the user's locale, is what you were saying, because this phone is in English.
Yeah, it's formatted with our hard-coded French.
Yeah, so we should be using,
instead of
the one you pick, it should be using the user's locale from the system default.
But in general, it should be localized at that point, the content default, right?
Yes, but that will not fix the dates.
No. But that's one of the many localization problems that this has.
One question on this part, though, like if everything after today is not usable, why is that? Like, okay, this is disabled, right? And it's not doing anything. Why it should be there?
Yeah, you're right.
I mean, you can just show that okay, this is the movie for today, and that's it. Like, you want to check tomorrow? You can come back tomorrow.
I assume after like a certain day, more days will unlock.
Yeah, would it be possible to see more than the current day?
Yeah.
So it is sometimes possible, I guess.
Okay. I guess.
But yeah, it might be worth seeing.
Yeah, because
if we can remove this.
I mean, from my point of view, it's more like this thing is taking so much physical space that you can do a lot more things with this if this doesn't provide any value.
Show that there's more days to scroll because this is wide and much. It's
you can again just do the
so you
half
can see
half
part of the item.
Just to show. For example,
the point is like there's no separation between the
something
cells.
Like this. And
something
like that. It is technically already partially visible, but you don't notice because it's wide. Yeah.
Normally you can add a fade or something, but because it's wide.
Yeah.
If we hit the big icon in the middle, the big button in the middle.
This one.
Yeah, is that another location?
Add to
favorites.
Okay, so the icon is a bit super
easy. Yeah, the icon makes me think.
Oh, what is that for?
Add to favorites.
This is
on the
previous page.
Yeah.
It's exactly the
same.
Same
actually.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, the icon is definitely
the,
confusing because favorites use like the love icons or
star.
A heart.
Yeah.
You can add a marker, but then also like a small plus or a small star.
Yeah.
And that's.
Yes. I would be careful with the star though, because you already have ratings as stars.
Yeah, that's true.
For non-French speakers, I thought this is like, oh, show me the location in the map.
Even if that said add to favorites, it would still be confusing. The icon on the inside and then the call to action seeming conflicting.
Yeah.
Oh, and the stars here are perfect, both the number and the stars.
Yeah. The stars are really good.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's tap on one of the three. Okay. Let's see. Movie pictures. Trailers.
What's the video player look like?
Okay, let's tap on it.
Oh, is this just the YouTube input?
No, it's not the YouTube player.
I
think
it's
a place.
Oh, I guess we can still.
Okay.
Yeah, it's the
DRM?
Yeah.
Yeah, DRM thing.
It is actually working.
Yeah, so, for me, I don't know. It looks good. It looks,
But there was a language speaker for the trailer, and yet all the content is in French.
Let's tap on it. So what is this?
The
original
language
without subtitles.
Oh,
okay.
So Vio is the original version.
Okay. Then there's this silent. Okay. The UI is okay. Video.
Do you fade to black at the end of the image?
Sorry.
On the poster, do you fade to black at the end?
I thought to the white.
No. I mean to show the buttons and the text. You are slowly fading to black, right?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Move the parallax
a
little
bit.
Yeah, it's pretty nice.
Yeah.
You know, like users
would
tend to scroll more.
It seems at the very end of the chapter. Go to one more time.
Yeah.
So we're fading. Maybe it was just this one.
Yeah.
So the thing is, if you're fading to white while the up bar is becoming fully opaque, you might not even want to fade to white and just leave the color background collapse into the up bar.
Yeah.
So like now, you wouldn't fade to white, you would just leave it there. And for
forget about it because in the end it will just blend in.
Yeah, I guess you had a problem though with link. At some point you have to curve.
Yeah, you can still, you would still see part of the image. You have the OK.
Unless it becomes right before the
you
need to experiment. the thickness of the star sphere is like too low compared to the button.
And it was bothering me too also. Usually I saw this have a stroke of
two, is that, are they also the primary action the user should be thinking about? Are they just rating it, the thing you really want most out of this page?
Yeah, this is a rating bar, rating for a.
But is that the primary action that you would want a user to do on this page? They came to this page so that you can get the data that they rated it. Like, that's their value add here.
But we came to it from the booking and ticket flow, so they probably haven't seen it yet. So maybe it's not the best primary action in this case. Maybe you want to have another reinforcement of the book the ticket now, or something like that.
Add it to the collection.
Yeah.
I have to say, I really like the button, the outline button style. It's really nice. And I use hearts here.
Oh, yeah. These are nice, but again, the outline looks a bit like.
No, it was more in the previous screen.
Do you invert the button when it's selected? Do you mean like the white?
Yes, it's a real art.
So right now it's not rated, right? So when it's selected, it turns to red or?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, this looks like, from my point of view, it's slightly misaligned.
Yeah.
it's slightly to the right. Yeah.
Also, like, do you really need the border around the eye?
I think just a heart standing there would indicate it's tabular.
Because if you only change the color, like one thing is if you completely invert the color, so you made like the white background and the black heart or something, then it makes sense. But otherwise,
it's also a common icon used for action events.
Yeah.
So I think users would be pretty accustomed to a heart being something that's an action.
Oh,
yeah, and
so
also
you,
if it's
so you kind of like this person.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
Nobody likes.
Okay. Yeah, it's not active on the on our backend, so we can like some of
the can we tap the people?
Is that a common problem with the users with partnership?
Try the one that we can't
that
like,
they couldn't favorite a specific or
okay.
Yeah, sometimes.
Well, but that's not
there should be like a disabled state for that. There's some confusion, like why can I save something? So there's
yeah, that's the fact that you know, like this is taken care. Like it could be a light background, so at least have the shadow on the button, just to have protection.
Yeah. And we use the same name because when Taylor opened the screen, actually we waited for the big image to be loaded, but you can at least use the thumbnail and then replace it normally with the same image but on a larger density.
But we don't add it.
Okay.
Yeah.
You don't have the thumbnail?
No, I don't have the big image for an actor.
Okay, so this one is the exact same one as the one in the screen before? Okay, so it's just the time that.
So you could do it.
Yeah, but now it's 30. Can you click on another one?
Do you have progressive images that you could serve from your backend?
You see that here it's blinking. So
yeah, but that's not yet on our backend.
But you can just upscale the thumbnail and make it even blurry if you want, and then just fade it to the correct one.
Yeah, because here you know, there is a loading time.
Yeah.
I would expect the exact same image as before just to be displayed in the meantime.
You can also cheat by using shared element transition
that
will buy you time to load the actual image.
And since it's using the same images, it's more reasonable.
And with the heavy blur on it, it's going to look like a loading state for the user, so I haven't seen that bad. That's a pretty common pattern.
One more minute for this app.
Sure.
Just one quick comment is that what I realized is that there's a specific styling in this app where, you know, like icons or something like that. But you see it's very different ones in this one, the love icon, the like icon, and this one is it's actually different. So if it's possible just to keep one design style for the whole thing so you have a stronger brand expression.
I would say one thing, which is like it says there's no biography, so why is there a button that says read the biography
right?
No, you can read them. There's no background.
So now you're sure.
Yeah. And also the same for the birth dates. Like if you don't have it, maybe not show it at all.
Actually, yeah, you can not show it.
It says no birthday.
And then birthday.
Oh, yeah.
Useful to say
okay.
There is no birthday.
Is that a message?
It's a comment.
Oh, comment. Okay.
Yeah, they definitely need some screen to see that this is the panel, some panel.
Some
because,
background.
Yeah.
Things.
Yeah, I think that's pretty much. I'm not sure if you guys have any more. I thought there's already a lot of information.
Can you try to share?
Sure.
That's to do.
That's good.
Yeah.
It might be me, but I'm a bit confused why you use hearts for some stuff and smiley faces for some other stuff
and
stars for others.
Right. And a pen for a song.
Yeah. So I'm not entirely sure what this is in terms of like.
The rating from the user.
Yeah.
What's the difference?
Yeah.
Yeah, what's the difference between the smileys and the stars?
Exactly.
Well, smileys is before the release date of the movie, and the stars after. So this is an intention to, I want to see this movie.
Right.
It's like a feeling before the release date, and the stars is after you've seen.
Can you go back to
okay,
so
it's explained here.
So are these smileys misordered? Like, clearly the one, this is like, I liked this the most, right? And this is like, I liked it.
But this is before,
okay,
so I think it's like.
So there's a scrollable, let's see if I can scroll. Okay, so that's for the star.
Okay, yeah, you might order those in like best to worst or whatever.
But how can you know have both? If you have one before the movie has been launched and one after? Because there was something on the stars as well, no?
I think it's.
This is weird.
Is it like critic reviews versus user?
You can move if you don't see the
yeah, this is really
it's your app, man.
Yeah. the movie is released, but we display the movie rating after 5 ratings or more.
But you still have 4 ratings right now? 2, 1, 1.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah. I think we're good.
Yeah, sure.
Sam, we'll do the next. That's a pretty nice app, really well done, but there is always new things to do, right?
Yeah,
animated vector robots everywhere. Also, because you can buy time for the animations, which is good. Okay, so the next up is activity run something. I think.
It needs adaptive icons.
Yes, it does need adaptive icons. It also might use a shorter name on the longer icon.
It
could
be run something. You know,
yes.
Like something.
Yeah.
So maybe it's the only adaptive icon.
Yeah.
Is
it? It looked like Cinema Rose might have been.
Okay, let me.
We are on my
changes. Sorry, man.
No worries.
I had to open the launcher one to change the shape.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you can do it. Okay.
But I didn't show there. I don't know.
No worries. Just do it.
Yeah. Today.
This is not the launcher.
Oh, it's not the launcher. Right. Right. Isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. So we can't do that.
For me, it looks blurry. Or maybe it's me. The phone looks blurry. I mean, on the screen.
The screen.
It is not very blurry, but it's not very unique.
Shape.
And I don't know, it's like.
It's like the default icon, like
for
phone icon.
Yeah. Let's start it.
Oh, so, where is the developer in the room? Just come join us, I'm really sorry. It's a good time.
Yeah.
What's your name?
That's the other one that didn't.
Yeah.
My name is Yuri. Actually, this is my pet project with 3 or 4 screens, and I didn't expect that you review it.
It arrived by like, I don't know, that wasn't my inbox. So.
First mistake. Actually, just
run activities of other applications and just send the intent so you can test something. And the main audience is developers. Okay. Yeah, the first run is takes time, but then I use it room like data.
You should explain why it's taking time the first time. Yeah. Just a little message saying, hold on.
I'm prodding the package manager.
Particularly
this design. Yeah, also that. So it's a good one. Maybe something animated is good.
Yeah,
and
it's not because it's targeted to developers, but it's UX.
Yeah.
Shouldn't
we have Phoenix as well.
We might actually have that developer like creating UX. So
none of you deserve good UX.
I think developers as an audience will be more critical of your app than
if this is a tool for work, then maybe you might consider not running ads on it and instead of having it pay. I would rather pay like 50p and not have ads at the bottom rather than have ads.
Do you want to turn off ads?
No, I'm saying that as a developer, if it's something that I'm using for work, I'm happy to pay like 50 cents or a euro or 2 euros for something that I use often instead of having ads.
Just go to Play Market.
Yeah.
Right now.
I mean, it's a Yale's
no way.
Sorry.
There's also a
how
Patreon.
Many apps do you have on your phone?
I mean, in total or just for this session?
No, in total.
I don't
really know, man.
I mean, this has been running for a couple of minutes now. 3 minutes.
Also connected to the internet?
No. So should all be local. Well, anyway, we can start
trying
with the
to
rest.
Kill the process and just relax. I don't know. Read that same other stuff.
Well, at least the UI's on
process. So the first thing you probably want to do is you want to move stuff out of OnCreate because that's taking forever to load the content.
First of all, load the interface.
Don't start loading in OnCreate. Put it in OnStart so that at that point at least the UI is visible and has been inflated, because otherwise you keep the white loading screen where there's nothing and it's not really great for as a user experience.
And on an older device,
this is
could be
strange
even
because I just run intent service for job.
But do you do a lot in the application on create, for example?
Or the first activity on create.
Yeah.
Like, where do you start the work?
Intent service.
Okay.
What kind of dependencies do you have?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah.
I don't know. Are you loading a framework or something?
Okay, so
it's not really
sure.
So there's one thing that is kind of obvious to me. This is like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's like the iOS share icon, and I'm a bit confused about why that is start intent now. I thought it was share with the wrong icon, but it's even different.
What would you use? It's like a button.
Yeah, I'm just gonna. Oh wait, no, that was just the ad.
I think the idea is to. Start an intent, so it's basically to open another app, right? From using this icon, it's to open another app, the new one. So I would use the exact same icon that you have in the Google Maps. I don't remember exactly where it goes, but there is this kind of rectangle, and the arrow goes straight to the right outside of the rectangle.
Oh yes, yes.
To show you that you're going to another app.
Yeah, that's more.
So I guess this is a way to compose. An intent that you want to launch on the device. So class name, this is going to be quite awkward to me, but on the device.
It would be interesting, for example, just to reach on your side all the package name and just have it highlighted.
But I think that's what he might have been trying to collect on the previous screen.
Do you
so
have
like a brand new
this one? So if I start typing,
but it should
hasn't loaded anything, I guess. Yeah.
You can select other options and don't input.
Yeah. There's one thing I want to say. I like the fact that you left the padding at the bottom.
Yeah.
So that is a common mistake, and you didn't do it.
Finally!
Yes.
Woo!
How many apps does he like?
That's fine.
That's normal phone, guys.
It looks like, is there a little bit of scrolling
issues
as well? Yeah, we're definitely dropping frames.
Yeah. I think the ads might also be to blame.
Yeah.
But I'm not sure.
if you hit the X on this ad, does it dismiss it temporarily?
So do you take the ads locally or load them every time you
just hide it.
Yeah, yeah,
actually,
it's
okay. The first one takes too much time because of I copy each icon into cache folder and then loads.
Maybe you want to do it on demand instead, or just do that for the ones that you see, and then load them as you go.
Yeah, I would definitely load the list without any of the icons initially.
You can
and
use
then have a separate task.
Yeah.
With like your image loader, like Glide or something, you can have a get the image from the input stream as you go, and only do it at that point.
It's definitely what was taking the most time. If you were doing those lookups and then the copy over the disk.
Yeah. That is definitely also impacting the scrolling as well. Okay, so let's pick.
Why do you want to copy them as opposed to just grabbing from the package manager? Did you see better performance going forward?
No. It takes too much time to get icon from package manager, especially in this adaptive icon, because I need to convert it, draw it to canvas, and save it by.
Sure, but other things that use many icons like launchers are often just taking it straight from the package manager or a content provider.
They're catching them at that point.
Yeah.
After they, do you keep them updated? Did they change?
It updates from time to time, but there is auto refresh.
Okay.
Mm.
Yeah.
But
I won't do it.
Yeah. But
don't do it.
All over again.
If for some reason there will be a loading time, you can always have like a nicer loading spinner, or maybe tell the user something that, yeah, we're loading your 502 apps.
Yeah.
Just
and
that
you
they
can
get
just have
idea.
A counter. Just
this
you
would
show
be
the
a
progression.
Great place for an animation.
But
also,
can you just add them as they come?
Yeah,
but
just start
you,
want
to
hunt,
yeah. One thing with the package manager querying is that if you start querying for details and icons, the query takes like 10 times as much. So you might want to do a first pass where you only get the list, and then you start getting all the details as you load them.
Yep.
So that might make the loading screen way faster because you don't have to wait for everything to go all the way.
And it'll ensure the user that it's not broken, which is right now the concern that we all had. Is this actually working?
Yeah.
We don't know.
And again, yeah, as you said, like having a count, it's like how many are still to be downloaded.
And something developers are using good phones sometimes, but sometimes, and that's good practice, they have dirty and horrible fonts to develop on.
Yeah,
just
get an Android
and,
Go.
And
Android
you can
Go,
imagine.
You will know.
Sorry?
Just get an Android Go phone.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
so
know.
Even if it's standard and not Word OS, then you can see that the loading was pretty long, but that's Nexus 6P, which is a kind of mainstream hardware right now. If you have a low-end device, it will take hours.
Yeah. And it will probably get killed by the activity manager very quickly because it can keep a lot of stuff in memory if you start loading all the images.
Yeah.
So you'll have to go. So let's expand Pimenta and expand the same. So I guess we're seeing the activity that we're in right now, which is this one. Oh, I can long press. I would have never thought of it. Because I was just trying to see the background.
So this is the package, and this is the activity. We're not seeing any differentiation between the two, aside from it being inset a little bit.
Yeah. So the other thing I would do is that instead of having long press, I would maybe have an overflow on the item. Because it is more explicit. I would have never been thinking that you can. Yeah.
Can you show the
This is just open.
Not
because you
opened myself. Well, at least it didn't take time this time. It does good caching. I just scrolled, I think.
Huh?
I'm not sure. Something happened. So open info. Okay, is this the same?
Yeah.
Okay,
that's a
shortcut,
right?
Yeah.
Home screen, I guess.
No, you can't change it. Maybe you can put an emoji.
Okay, so you said creating a
window.
Okay.
Thank you.
I didn't know where to find it. It's probably sitting next to the actual icon.
Yeah.
Well, they're equivalent. So.
Yeah.
But why was there two dialogues? Because one said add your own screen and the other said create show.
I think the second one is the system.
System window.
So the first one is to say what you want the label to be on the
yeah.
shortcut, but then you just tell the system
yeah.
create the shortcut, and the system will ask the user, are you sure you want to create the
yeah.
shortcut?
It's also available now.
Maybe. I'll go to the AR settings again.
Yes.
Oh, so, oh yeah, because it was creating the icon. But, yes.
No.
Yeah, I know, but it's taking time.
We have 1 more minute for this.
Well, it wasn't there.
Cold.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you have an answer?
Uh-huh.
The answer is no.
If you can go back to the search screen.
You mean this or?
No,
maybe
it was the launch.
The intent
screen.
So, great shortcut.
No, at the top.
Oh, this
the
one.
Mystery
yes. The mystery box.
Yes. The one thing I wanted to say here is that we should definitely have vertical alignment on these tags.
Yeah.
And also, they all have the same icon, so in this case.
It's the same
yeah.
dialogue.
If it is
the title.
If it is the same icon, then we should remove the icon.
Yeah.
But if we can differentiate, then different icons.
Is the icon clickable? Is it like paste?
No,
I think it's just an indicator of item.
That's for developers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That looks very good.
What if I misconfigure something?
Okay, so the icon change when you have something.
So I'm gonna start it now with just a flag.
You can see the arrow.
Okay.
That's pretty much what I
okay, yeah.
Yeah. And maybe you might want to do some pre-validation before enabling the two bot, because you don't have an action, you don't have a package.
But this is okay. You just select the mind type and.
Yeah, but you need to have either an action, data, or a target package, and you have neither.
But today, maybe
exactly.
You never know.
That's V2? You can sell V2?
Yeah. Try the history, I'm assuming, right?
Yeah.
Okay. That's the.
This one. So if I tap it, I guess it just repopulates the content that we had before.
Okay.
And I just want to see the leap. Okay, this is for all. Can I delete one? Yes.
Ooh. Oh, you can create a shortcut.
Yeah.
That's yes.
Okay.
Maybe instead of dialogues, for at least the text input, you can just align them in the
page.
In
the
list,
yeah. Just put an edit text directly in
the list.
Yeah.
I think we're all good. Thanks a lot, man.
For all the people that need to test that.
Great.
Your
Me?
Turn? Yeah. Liberty Rider. Who is the developer? Come on stage, guys. Thank you. So just introduce yourself, but just in one sentence, what your app is doing.
Hi, everyone. I'm Sebastian, and this is Hugo. We are two members of the team which developed the Android the Liberty Rider application. And the main objective of the application, it helps to save lives, motorcyclists' lives, by detecting accidents during their ride. So when we detected an accident and qualified as real, we try to contact us during 2 minutes to see if it's okay or not. And if not, or if we don't have answer, we call 911 for you and give it some information, last location, phone number, and a contact of you to trigger some rescue.
Nice. I think for this review, just 1 point, it would be interesting to focus on UI, of course, but on UX and how to make your process and your life-saving process the better and the most efficient.
We have some required information to call 911, so
okay,
it's part of onboarding.
Yeah, great.
Okay, so it's basically after you said that you detect the accident, so
yeah.
It's after you
make
an accident. Yeah, so an accident happens.
Yeah.
And then you say, okay, an accident happened. And
yeah.
Like
we
it's not before the accident happened.
No, the user has to sign in to enable the app.
Okay.
Way
sure.
Before.
And then it sits
yeah,
in
yeah,
the
yeah,
background.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. And
okay.
Then you crush test it.
So we kind of download it in order to configure it so it can serve our lives, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so this
so.
Is the first time. Yeah. Oh, you want to say something?
Yeah, it's a French app.
Yeah.
I can see that.
For the moment, because we are connected with 911 system.
So what does it say? It explains what it does, or?
Yeah,
yes.
So I gave free assistance. You can share your ride with your friends.
I like that this is peeking through.
Yeah, we talked about it before. The
and there is the
nice.
There is the indication of
what?
The next picture on the on
yeah.
the right,
yeah.
but not on on the left.
Works.
On the
left.
In the left.
Okay, so it's about.
No.
Yeah.
There is a new portrait.
Yeah.
Okay, on the portrait. Okay, and this is to log in, I guess?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sign in and to
yeah, you can continue or
skip.
Or skip.
This is, what is the left one?
Skip the two.
Skip?
Yeah. Okay.
Look at
you skip to log in.
Interesting.
I think you can skip the onboarding, but then you still end
yeah,
up with
yeah.
the...
We can skip the onboarding, but we need to have an account
yeah.
view because of, we have...
Yeah,
any information to provide to 911,
so
it's complicated. To
okay.
So
oh, I got it. So this is next
okay.
one on the
yeah.
slide, and this is just to log in.
Yeah.
Okay. You should probably
okay.
Remove the skip button at the very end.
Yeah.
One
to the right.
At the last.
Wait, when we're done
oh, yeah.
at the last slide,
because on the very last
so
slide there is nothing
yeah.
to skip.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's nothing to go next to.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just continue with my Google icon.
Let's.
After
my
just
I will play you to Google.
You sure?
Yeah. Ship
it.
I'm not a driver, so
it's
good. And then right
hand.
Oh.
So
yeah,
we need to enter your phone.
Yeah.
I want
you could
sorry.
You could
close your eyes.
Stop recording. So if you had an icon that indicated to prompt
yes.
permission.
Thank you. Okay, so I just
that's
finished
cool.
to Android my. No, that's fine, Sebastian.
It's
fine.
He doesn't care.
No, it's good, it's good.
He wants them to call.
He's been there forever.
Yeah. Too bad.
Suddenly.
Okay, now you have to add a
call. Call you late at night.
Because we have to. Well, because we are sharing the URI with, like,
family members.
And then he can follow your ride in real time. And then
so the message
that you have to have a contact to use the app.
So I noticed you didn't verify the phone number?
No.
No.
Yeah.
Just speak as a Android contact.
Okay. Well, I meant for your own phone number that you were
yeah.
on
yeah,
the previous screen.
For
so if I mistyped that,
yeah.
what's going to prevent that from moving forward? There's no SMS verification or anything?
No, because it costs.
Some visual notes on the screen.
Yeah.
Do not hesitate to have padding.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's actually a very attractive screen, but
yeah.
the padding is driving me crazy.
Yeah.
And I guess they also saw that, but the icon, I guess it's mathematically centered in the sitcom, but actually you want it to be visually centered.
Okay.
For me, it looks like it's on the bottom right.
Yeah. Okay.
It's not
really but centered. I want to say something. As I mentioned, you don't do any verification for the phone number,
no.
and I think it's fine. But maybe you want to add some kind of, I don't know, maybe to show it to the user again, to say, okay, this is the number you entered, are you sure this is correct?
A kind of confirmation?
Yeah,
yeah
sort
yeah,
of,
okay.
because this is like really important
okay.
for the
yeah.
number to be correct, right?
Okay.
Twice.
And
okay.
another question, do you have the possibility to change the phone number, this phone number
yeah.
from the
yeah.
app?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, and I will want to enter the contact.
Yes.
Do I have
a
yeah. number of authentication systems? Like,
yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
You know what you could do for the phone number? You could ask for the permission to auto-detect their phone number as an
yeah.
option as well to help.
Okay.
Yeah, but
it doesn't
work.
Always.
Neither
does
the user typing it in
manually. I don't
know
this guy. And just? Okay, that's a good scenario. I just get one.
Yeah.
Just for the example, you can untick the checkbox because a real SMS go to a people a friend of you. So
right now?
No, not right now, but when you click
okay.
on
okay.
go button. So
but
you can just untick the two checkbox. Just for the damper.
But I cannot make this guy disappear from this.
Yeah, you can. You can, but there is a way. I don't know if you can find it.
Long press.
I try.
But it's okay. It's okay for demo. It's okay for demo.
That's not discoverable.
Not very obvious.
If you make it look like. An item that is distinct from the background, then it's hard to dismiss. Might be slightly more.
I know. But I didn't. There were like two screens for me to allow you
to.
Why?
Because it's an error. But we are working on it.
Yeah, there should be just one screen. I mean, once I go, okay, let's add a contact, maybe then I can. Permission to then just go down.
We have some legacy workflows, so we are redesigning one by one, but.
Okay.
The fact that this is saying SMS is not clear. So you ask for permission without saying much, first of all. But here, the fact that you were about to send SMS, it should really be like, a full message.
In this space, we are not going to send SMS.
Okay.
So they are adding the contact to which they will send an SMS.
Yeah, just to prevent some.
I assume you will notify them that they are at the.
I think you have to hit
just
the back.
Just back.
Accept.
Yeah. So in the green, it'd be much more clear to have a check something to say you've accepted it. It looks like you're just undoing it when you go back.
And now?
So,
okay.
Why is the buttons all like me?
It is running.
Yeah. Okay, so let's take. No, it doesn't scroll. Okay, so here we know the paddings and stuff. And I mean, does this mean that we chose someone?
Yeah, it's like there is a continue button, but there is also the add one.
I know, so maybe we want to show that we did add someone?
Yeah,
the
definitely
the button moved. It was add, and now it's continue.
Yeah, but I want to see, okay.
I think this should just automatically continue.
And I want the confirmation.
Yeah,
I want to see the person's name.
Okay, we chose Marianne, this is your.
And there is a list, and then the button.
Yeah.
Okay.
For example.
And once again, visually, you have two kinds of button with some with gradients, and the other one was plain, color.
And the color seems wrong.
It's the
other
like
no, what's
that? In the preview screen?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Like the orange doesn't look
backwards.
Yeah.
What
okay.
is now?
And now it's like you can start the protection, pressing go, and then you.
It's just
okay,
like
so
a tutorial on
the
end
of
onboarding.
I get it. So we did like the onboarding already, and now we're just starting. I think I would do sort of shorter onboarding and like to confirm that we have all the information. I think it might be slightly better to say, okay, you logged in, now let's create your profile and show me on one screen all the things that I need for my profile and then I can edit it. So this is your phone number and then I can see it the entire time and then maybe edit it. And then below my phone number, maybe have the list of the contacts. And then I can edit them and see them the entire time and to confirm it. And this way I can see like, okay, this is my profile, it is fine, now I can continue. And it would be easier for me to know what kind of other data do you need for me and to confirm
everything
it. On the same screen, one screen, first screen that you see for the onboarding, and the only one actually. And only when it's ready, I can get to this screen.
It kind of feels right now while you're doing the onboarding, it feels like the onboarding is done, and after you put your number and then you go to the actual app, because I had never seen the main screen of the app. So when you get to adding the contacts, it's kind of feeling like you have finished the onboarding and you're doing something else.
Okay.
So maybe try to have a unified design language throughout the flow.
Okay.
Maybe automatically redirect on screen. Contact is sent.
Well, when you're done, I mean, if you're done, then yes, there's no point in showing again, okay, now you're done.
Especially if you have all the information on one screen and you can always edit them, then it's very easy to say just I'm done.
It feels slightly shorter. I feel that we want to create a shorter onboarding always. It's like our goal to create a shorter onboarding. So maybe try to do it. The first one where you explain what's going to happen in the app and the slides and everything is good because I need to trust you and I need to know what's going to happen and why am I going to give you all this information that I'm about to give you. And then maybe create like just a shorter experience, with less screens.
Just a question. It would be good to put this screen in the onboarding because you don't see the screen before you end the onboarding.
I don't You mean in the initial carousel?
Before adding context, do you think it would be good to show this screen with like
I think it would be confusing if you show things. Like, it's really important, as you said, that the users fill in all the necessary details.
Mm.
So what is kind of lacking right now is the feeling of being in one singular flow.
Okay.
It feels like you're jumping back and forth,
mm.
and you're going to the settings, and you're doing adding context and all that stuff. So I don't think this is necessary that you show this before you finish the onboarding,
okay.
but that you make it different enough that when the initial configuration is done, it's clear that this is the old screen and all that you've done is done. Maybe you could keep the configuration dialog as a recap of this is your phone number, these are the people that will be warned when you start to ride. So you can cut down on the, let's say, static onboarding and just use the presenting the information that the user gave you to confirm and at the same time to inform how it will be used.
Okay,
so I finished the onboarding and then I got this screen and at first I got like some stars on the top which looked like some kind of cool gamification thing. Okay, and now I just closed the app and I don't see it anymore, so why?
Like, first open on the app, you have like...
Because I got the stars.
Notification, if you press notification, it disappears.
You might need that more. Was it like have it dismiss and leave it there until the user is actively dismissed?
Where can I see it? Like the entire stars I just got?
In the gesture management, yeah. And then like in the shop.
This?
With the coin, yeah.
Okay.
Maybe you should pass the
thing. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So this is basically the screen that I see at first.
Yeah.
Like, why would I open it? Do I need to configure something here? Or
no,
it's okay.
You need
just
to start
just
it when you start.
It's gonna start
your
background tracking.
You're on your motorbike.
Okay.
You
so
need to start
before,
to ride.
Okay. So before every ride, I have to like to do
yeah,
it myself.
Yeah. It's manually for the moment. Sorry.
Can you use the activity recognition to know when people are biking?
It's also super precise.
For now, it's not.
No, it's we're working on, but not for the moment. Only manually for the moment, but we are working on automatic process to.
Also, I guess like if you have Bluetooth on your bike.
It's part of the solution.
There are a bunch of ways that I think that you can either detect it or even just detect it something that you might start to ride, even just by the hours of the day or something like that, and then to ask the users if you want to enable it.
And
all right, and what?
It's a young app, so yes, we have a lot of improvements.
What does this say? This means
it's
that
if
I have another
passenger.
Passenger. Yeah.
So it's kind of cool.
But then what?
Why do I need it?
That doesn't make me think
it's
cool.
Looks like a fab more than a phone.
Yeah.
But when you are not alone, we are going to call 911 and ask for two ambulance.
I see.
Because we have a passenger, so we know it. So,
so
we tell it to 911 to have two ambulances or
anything like
that.
It could be like a switch. The switch between one and two.
It's
nice.
What's this? Okay.
When
you want to share
for your
contact that you choose or not.
Okay.
You can choose to share or not your right with your contact.
Okay.
And then it will send a SMS, a message with a link and people can see
you in real time.
You're right.
Okay, so you contacted them
the
before.
Yeah.
Okay.
And this will by default send it to all the contacts that you added.
Yeah.
Okay.
And SMS is the only way to do it right now?
For the moment.
Okay, let's go with that.
So this is a good placement of the location.
Yeah.
It's very obvious.
Yeah.
That I need it and so on.
Good.
I want to say something about the notification you got before with the monetization, the gamification stuff.
Yeah.
It should be much more like, you know, animated.
What does it say?
You can cancel on the.
What does it say? It sends Mario on the SMS.
What are you doing? You can cancel it with the lap button.
Can we test a crash by throwing his phone against the wall?
Yeah.
You can do it with your phone, right?
So,
I have another something that is when you start.
Yeah, you can skip.
Oh, I like it. It goes back.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Nice. Can you start the ride again, please?
Sure.
Can keep
it. To go back.
Sure.
I love it.
So, but when this is done, you will notice that the duration now that it goes to 10 seconds, it moves. I would rather leave it. Humans are attracted by motion, so be very intentional with motion, because otherwise it's distracting. I mean, you're probably riding at that point, you don't care, but still.
Is it lagging?
There is a notification.
Oh, it's a notification?
Yeah,
it's foreground. You have a silver chest.
Yeah, definitely.
What does the action do?
Stop.
That.
Yeah.
Nice. I think it's a really good action to put here. So
you can stop or pose, because you can have pose
yeah,
in your ride.
But from the notification, I can only stop from here, right?
Yeah, maybe you want to add pause as well there.
Such nice motion, and I would say personality in this screen of your app. It would be nice to see the surface with maybe like custom animations, drawings.
A little bit more catchy and
easy
to spot.
If you make it an ongoing priority notification, like Maps does, where it has the giant green notification, we do the same for you.
Okay.
And it's kind of the same thing as navigation, and we do want the user to remember to stop it or remember.
Yeah, this is an excellent use case for
it. 1 minute.
If you can add like remote use the notification, so you have the actual stop and pause button inside.
Oh yeah.
Use the same.
Okay.
Although that might start to conflict once new versions of Android come out, or with other manufacturers.
Okay.
No.
It's
not it wouldn't work, but it might conflict.
I know what you're saying. I think you're meaning the actions, not like
sharing
a custom remote view.
No, I mean a custom.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It would conflict with the design.
Because then every time it upgrades, they will have to.
It's a summary of your ride.
Yeah.
So you see the map view is not centered on one route.
Yeah.
It could be good to just have a zoom in.
We don't have move, so we don't have position.
Yeah,
so
right.
For the moment, it's
okay. So
the world,
but the first
when you have a real move, you have a real draw on your map, and you are center on your right.
Oh, I did something bad.
So you can
actually
get the last known location.
And what is that?
Better than the center.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's Facebook and share and the like because.
Accident detection is completely free, but we need to need to survive. So
the empty states that you took care of this like really nicely then, where we don't have data to show that sometimes you just instead of showing just an empty
like
screen. What does this do? What do we add here?
Here's like a trip. You can ride with your friend.
Yeah.
With your friend.
And then you are
it's a social part of the
Okay, and it takes care of the validation, which is nice.
If
We recommend rethinking SMS verification with something that people, even as a pay-for service, that mistake by a user would be critical to the business app that you gave with this app.
Okay.
If they screwed that up, potentially they're unable to be, emergency services can't get in contact with them, and then that's a really negative scenario.
Okay.
Like, this is the main, so this is the main color, like the this red, orange
gradient.
But now you're using it as a negative action.
Yeah,
and
okay.
The positive you're using like a green, which is, it's weird. So it should always be that either you use a different color or the positive should
that's
be
the
same.
That's true. Yeah, maybe gray or black or something.
Yeah. But
what does this do?
You're choosing the kind of categories.
Wait, but you can set the white.
What?
Let's just add some information and go to the next.
Oh, one. I did. Then I went back and didn't
say
the information. I
also
see
you're going back and forth between toasts and snack bar.
Okay. Excuse me?
Yes.
Just one rather suggestion. I mean, you not handle the situation when you run out of battery. So I mean, maybe it will be good to show some kind of alert at onboarding or to constantly send some kind of notification when you low of battery, because it will be a bad situation when you're out of memory, out of battery, and you try to call this person that you cannot handle this situation, and you call 911
you're saying it's like, is this a relaxed trip or is this like a sustained trip?
If you're wanting to add context, like the type of trip that they're taking, or information that you might need to act on, it's probably also the destination that they intend.
Okay.
That way you'd give more context to your
subscribe.
Right?
Okay.
You know, if they went way up the trip, they should be alerted.
You get the flus.
Yeah, like your coin naming.
Yeah.
Kind of like
for French. That's very French. I think we must really conclude because we are 15 minutes late.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you
so much.
More application, but we won't be able to do it. I don't know if you have spare time and developers of the next application, maybe.
Frishti.
We can do it very quickly. For all the people that are hungry, just you can go away. It's really not a problem. If you are still interested, just
it's
stay
very
with
warm
us.
Here, you can use the application Frishti as well.
Sorry?
Yeah, it's a food delivery service, so you can use it as well.
Yes. Should we take 10 minutes to do it and then conclude for real? Is he looking for everybody? Or are you so angry that we need to go?
I'm not.
Okay, let's take the last. Okay? Who wants to do it? Lisa, you know? On time? So just come on stage. Round of applause for you. Introduce yourself very quickly and what your app is doing.
Yeah. So hi everybody. I'm Danny, working on the Frishti company currently, and so it's basically food delivery service, like a very well-known Deliveroo, Uber Eats and stuff. But it's way behind it because it's not relying on the restaurants or anything else. It's our recipes, our cookers that are every day cooking and to deliver to customers.
So it's really great if you have time between this application.
Otherwise,
you can see
that.
You know, about deliveries, food.
Well, you can order something, but.
I know about
Okay.
Yeah.
No way.
That's true.
You have your Google Pay hooked up to this?
I hope so.
Lunch is on? I know. All right. First things first, if we're looking at the icon, the adaptive icons, it's going to make this be much more consistent with everything else in the launcher. I think we'll cover a few of these now, but
I think one thing that has to be said about adaptive icons, you haven't really used them so far, but in P they're really visible, so you really want to make sure that you use an adaptive icon.
Switch the status bar to dark, at least for this, because you have like white on white.
So we had a little bit of a long splash screen to the onboarding.
Yeah, what was
A4? All in French.
No, it's good. It's fine.
Yeah.
But what is
French? Yeah, it's a Paris-based company, so we are not delivering it away than Paris and its borders.
Just a question, why the splash screen took something like 3 or 4 seconds?
For the onboarding. Yeah, the onboarding, and we are loading something, like configuration file from the AWS.
Okay, so using a network.
Yeah.
And if there is no network, of course you cannot not order, so the application
so
is not working.
We are going right after and going to the menu.
Is the configuration needed for the onboarding?
No. I like the
so can you load it while the user is on the onboarding instead of loading before the user gets to the onboarding? So
yeah,
you can just skip the splash screen and go straight to the onboarding.
It's not on the device.
It might save people some time.
Yeah.
Definitely.
So I'm looking at this onboarding experience. It's I love these big, beautiful URL images that you have up front. You know, it's definitely appetizing. You're putting your content forward for a user that's going to be like, really appealing. They're understanding the value add right away.
Yeah.
But I don't think you're being very efficient in handling the images. I'm noticing frame drops. First load, there was even, it wasn't super responsive with the gesture as well.
Okay.
Once there's a cache, the responsiveness for gestures is fine, but I'm still seeing a little bit of frame drops as you're kind of dumping these in and out of memory.
Okay.
Since they're big, they're gonna, you know, they're big, beautiful images, they're gonna be higher size.
Yeah.
So you might consider what sort of like WebP images you might wanna be using, what sort of compression on these you might wanna be using to display them.
Yeah.
And then being a little more aggressive is when you're dropping these and pulling them back in memory to display them on the screen.
Yeah. And
scaling properly as well.
How about the text? It's just a row front, just in front of the picture. It's not really stable when you read it.
Okay.
So there are a few ways to just avoid the,
the
for example, for Fritchy, you have this kind of reflect on the tomatoes here. So you are not sure it's an edge. It's really not straightforward.
Okay. Maybe a shadow or something.
Shadow or
at least the background looks like
it's an elevation.
Yeah.
For sure.
But also you control the images, but you can't control where the text is going to end up.
Even in some of these, like these indicators are on the plate, so that's not as
exactly.
noticeable.
Yeah.
I would add some very slight, like you could animate slightly the indicators as well, because everything is so beautiful that you could. And add like a super, super soft parallax effect with the images, just enough that it's like,
okay.
Again, if we can delay the location.
Yeah, same thing,
absolutely.
Yeah.
So I'm going to allow it.
Yeah, of course, we don't
know. Good luck.
Taylor is like, it's really the
so
time.
You had a loading animation that I don't know if people noticed that was like a gray that was going across, a shimmering. That almost looked like an error in the beginning. Like that didn't come across very strongly as loading. It was a little too subtle, almost looked like a screen rendering issue, like is the GPU on this phone going out. You might want to be a little more explicit in some sort of loading animation.
Okay.
It also kind of conflicted with the general just like material design, which you're doing pretty well through the rest of this so far. So you might figure out an alternative loading gesture.
It is a little interesting and I think offsetting how one of your items has elevation.
Yeah.
This is not usual unless the user has selected it. If you just want to highlight it, I would use some other visual treatment rather than elevation.
You can just merge it with the
I have to say I like the fact that the full bleed images are not actually entirely full bleed and
this is exactly
them.
What
so
we're talking about in the other
these should be snapping though.
Yeah. Well, it is, but not like aggressively, maybe. Not
well,
enough.
If I just do one gesture, it just keeps it's going.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. It should immediately. If I just do a single
for
swipe,
certain
it should immediately
so
snap to the
how,
next one.
Okay.
This is how Oversecure with the default snap pager helper works. So this is the default behavior. And I think it's actually okay.
It depends.
It's not the same as a view pager.
Yeah.
But maybe that's okay.
But it, is the user? How, what are they doing with these images that are in the screen?
Actually, you can click up, and you'll see like a news explaining like the second one, or like if you are a new customer, we are explaining to you what is Freshly, what are we doing, why home meals are great and stuff.
But you would expect them to kind of read one after the other after the other the first time that they're walking through this application?
Just click on them, and yeah, of course, after maybe switching to the other one, taking another time.
Well, on top you have the map.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm not sure it's really relevant for this screen exactly. Because
yep.
It's supposed to be illustrating that you are looking for the address of the user on top.
Okay.
And I'm not really sure it brings interesting content. It's more confusion.
Okay.
Confusing
well,
than
that. Yeah. Actually, we're doing another version,
yeah,
like a V3 of the app, just to yeah, purify it. And there's not the image first in the old.
So that's going to potentially have issues as you scroll up on bigger devices or down.
Yeah.
This text not being a vector.
Yeah, and there is several typographies. So here you're using a custom font from the company, I guess.
Yeah.
But on the screen before it was RoboJo.
Yeah.
So we probably only switch to one
yeah.
typo.
There's
another
type.
Can you
open
it again? The same?
Okay.
Yeah.
Another. The correct at the top goes away as a scroll is not very.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Can I? Oh, I can scroll it off as well.
No, but if you scroll up the text, can you see that
yeah,
the button at the top
yeah.
is
yeah.
gone?
Yeah.
Which is like a bit weird.
Yeah.
I mean, you either just don't have it, or
actually,
you
want it
to
just
yeah.
immediately go
down.
Is it clickable?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. You can tap on the top, and it's going to go up.
So I tap this one. First time and I got no response after the second time.
Have you tried drawing especially the map under the status bar? Because here we have a yellow status bar and it looks like it's
yeah.
For me, yeah, maybe I'm used to dark status bar,
mm-hmm.
but here I would expect you know the map to draw.
Okay.
And then,
just
to
make it more immersive.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
That would be consistent with the start screen as well, with
yeah.
the
yeah.
backwards.
Yeah.
These also don't seem too consistent between each other. Like this one has the image along the top, clicked
yeah.
off.
Yeah.
Yeah, it depends on the news.
Some of the others are, you know, just like
yeah, there's a lot of different on families and weight.
Yeah.
But I know it's not your part,
yeah.
the design part, but yeah, for me there's too many different
okay.
Text
appears. Maybe too aggressive, but
yeah.
Well,
it's
you do have your own custom font.
That's
yeah.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I
did.
Yeah.
Oh,
on
one? But it's not the same one. There
yeah,
is one with
yeah.
serif.
Serif.
And
oh yeah.
There is no serif running. Oh yeah. Yeah. Sure. Oh. Not sure.
This down carrot here, bringing this up with a full office.
Sorry.
This carrot here.
Yeah.
Bringing up a full screen or like a modal, like you're doing.
Yeah.
That doesn't feel like the expected behavior.
Yeah. It's another decision, but it's always like to have the menu behind. Where you can switch behind and yeah, like.
But it could be like the.
No, I think he's saying that the you know
yeah, like
with the where whenever possible.
Cool.
Yeah, that looks like a spinner thing and it brings up a completely
yeah.
different
yeah.
thing.
Okay.
And it's also the same icon that you use on the panel that you bring up to dismiss it, which is kind of.
If
yeah.
you could invert it.
Yeah.
The arrow up, then maybe it would make sense.
I'm almost thinking it would. At the current behavior, I would expect it would be something like an overflow menu or something.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah.
That's something
yeah.
behavior I'm saying.
Like, this is nice.
Try to click on the
I like the
square
the way, the very clear way that you show
no,
all the times and
you're
the
missing,
run. Yeah.
Like, you're missing the primary click on a lot of these for some reason.
Oh yeah.
On a lot of these new screens, like the first tap is always ignored.
Yeah. Okay. There's no feedback on many things.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's working this one.
Like,
probably retained right.
It's just a result.
Sometimes there's a problem with focus.
So you okay? You could animate the transition as well for the phone.
Yeah.
Oh, I like how
nice.
The icons going into the frame.
Yeah.
That's really nice.
But you can click next elements, right? You don't scroll.
I would like, as I'm scrolling through this list, this snaps afterwards.
Okay. Yeah.
And I would like it to kind of, to keep in sync with this gesture. That's
okay.
Right here.
Because also they go parallax a bit.
But is there anything below?
Yeah.
No, you can't.
Because it kind of looks like it's
yeah,
fast.
Something
yeah.
Yeah.
It does.
Is
So maybe you don't want to have the bars ending at the edge of the screen, because it's the same hue that implies elsewhere that there's other content.
Okay, yeah.
So like with the carousels where you have the part of the image picking in on the sides. So maybe just put some padding.
Okay.
Hamburger menu button here, pulling this up.
Whoa,
feels,
it's a secret menu.
Feels,
but
it's not discoverable, but it's not discoverable in the standard way,
yes.
And it's very confusing to each other.
You think so? Like,
yeah, if you put the menu, the hamburger menu down on the bottom,
yeah, actually
in a fob,
cute, like it's original.
Original's not always good.
But I like the culture of the two buttons, and
yeah, if,
do you have the gesture?
No.
In general, there is the advice to only have one fab.
That's true.
I know that there are even Google Maps. many apps ignore it, but I'm not sure this is a case where we need to ignore that.
Also, because that is not an action.
Yes.
Also,
it is navigating.
It's a missed opportunity. It could be a real hamburger given the
type of
map.
True. With the way you have the map and stuff up here, you could make this into a collapsing toolbar and have the appropriate menu.
Yeah.
Yes.
Sure,
I really don't see any need
it.
For this app to have a different navigation icon than every other app.
Yeah.
If you should deviate only when there's anything.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or you can just go for a bottom tab if you can arrange the navigation.
Yeah. This snap it's losing frames, it doesn't feel like that would be a really nice place to add some animation. Tap one of these for it to come over.
Mm-hmm.
It seems like you might be doing the animation, but just with the frame drops, it's not coming through.
It's rebugging the images as well.
That's where
the
blink.
Image loader is applying the fade in, and it should probably.
It seems like a good place for payloads. So there's like the video, we're not doing that already.
Yeah. And if I was scrolling through this and you were snapping the bottom content to that each time, that would feel a lot more natural.
Yeah,
okay. As well.
Yeah.
One and then the next.
It's like a fun app.
It's building
recycle
reviews.
Are you hiring?
We found a group.
We need a support group for recycle reviews.
It's nice.
We got a lot of content here.
Yeah, there's a lot of
content.
Right.
Can you search?
How do I?
Can you show like a progress bar? Scroll bar? Do you know how many there are?
Yeah.
You could show how many people you go.
Okay. Also, giving the user some quick way to get back up higher in the list. I'm having to scroll.
Yeah.
So
they also
don't seem
they don't
I'm
seem
so
to be
hungry.
Sorted.
It's
sorted by types of meals. So the end is like snacks. Yeah, but inside of the mains are not sorted alphabetically, so it's hard to find what you're looking for because it's a bit like.
You might even break this out into multiple categories into
content,
like having it all in one plan list.
Yeah.
It feels like a lot.
It would be nice if you do fast scroll with the scroll bar. You show the categories, so you can directly snap to the categories you want. You know how in the context it does with my letter of the alphabet.
Some
sequence.
Yeah.
Beers.
There's some flickering of the nav bar. Which is a bit weird.
Is this an image right here? Yeah, this is definitely an image, right? I would definitely use a font with a scalable background, like a bigger background.
It's a font.
Is it a font? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
because
in other parts of the app we saw typography that wasn't
in this one,
just create a custom text view that does that style.
Use
it everywhere.
Spans.
Yes.
Spans everywhere.
Okay, it's hard to tell, this isn't clickable, it seems. This one does pop up. Those are treated very similarly, the only difference is the hero cost here, but the brakes are...
And there is a misalignment with text.
Yes.
Yeah.
Not because it's centered. I think so. Look at that center.
Only the text is simple.
So you have two different types of like UI screens that you're mostly pulling through. You have this kind that's like more of a modal and it's kind of off-mounted on the top. And you have the full screens that are coming up. And both of them are animating from the bottom.
Yeah.
But you have these two different distinct UI styles. You might choose a different animation for the full screen ones than the modal. The modal definitely seems like it should come up from the bottom, right? You can even swipe down to dismiss it like I'm doing here.
Mm-hmm.
I would think that one of these full screens might be.
Or maybe could take over the modal.
Or
like like a circular reveal into that, for example.
There's a lot of nice animations here. It seems like there's some performance issues to work through.
Yeah.
For those to really shine.
Get that to switch.
I would think that if you tap this entire row,
it
toggles
it.
Okay. Can you make
the
noise
of it
on towards the board?
Yeah,
it's
listen, lots of nice things here.
All right. I think we're all good.
Very good.
Thank you again. I'm sorry for inventory. Won't be able to do it today, this year. Let's see you next year. Okay? Yeah, of course. You will be here.
Thank you.
It's not a question.